Well, back home in a Melbourne teenager set a new angling record, but it's not because his catch was supersized, though it was pretty big. Ryan Gazzola hooked this southern bluefin tuna off the Mornington Peninsula. It's 195 centimetres long and 135.4 kilos.
Mate, that's 100 kilos.
Move! We got him!
But why it's such a big deal, it turns out that the CSIRO had tagged it 29 years ago off WA when it was just a year old and about 52 centimetres long. Now, that's 12 years before Ryan was even born, and in fish terms, the longest time at liberty in Australian history. And the fisherman himself, Ryan Gazzola, joins us. Now, Ryan, congratulations on this catch. Just how did it all happen?
It's a bit surprising, to be honest. It's something that... Oh, I guess I can't really write about. Like, I didn't think this was going to happen.
We heard it was quite a team effort as well. Can you talk us through that? Why?
Yeah, so with tuna, it's very important to have like a good team with you. So I was on the rod, rod and reel, and that's basically strapped into me. So I've got to fight 4 hours of that fish, basically just me and him, like battling it out. And then Jack Carmichael was on the wheel driving, and then Max was there spotting me, making sure nothing happened to me and making sure that we didn't run over the fish, because I couldn't talk. Like, I was so focused. They were yelling at me to talk, but I just couldn't talk.
You're reeling it in. I can imagine it's quite heavy. You glimpsed an orange tag attached to the tuna. What do you do next?
So we got it in the boat and realised there was the orange tag in it. And basically, when we got back to the ramp, we weighed this fish in and, yeah, it went 135.4 kilos. And my stepdad and his mate, Damien and Ben, they were filleting the fish, making sure it was all taken care of and everything. And I thought, I'm going to go have a look at this tag, to go have a look what it is. So we cut it out and, yes, we were just admiring it. Like, I had a tag in it and stuff. And then the next day, Ben is like, oh, give Wind Against Tide a message, like just give him a message and say, oh, I got this orange tag, it's from Hobart and all of this stuff. I was like, yeah, no worries. So I text the guys from Wind Against Tide, and before you knew it, all these fisheries officers and the CSIRO, I think, they were all texting me and saying, like, This is big, like, you need to get the head, we need this and that. I'm like, yeah, I can get you everything, but the head might be a bit of a problem. the head was actually in the bin at Hastings.
Because the authorities wanted you to cut the head off and send it to them. Now, presumably you can't put it in the parcel. So, I mean, what were they expecting?
Oh, I was like, they're going to want this head, but what are they, like, how are they going to get it over to them? Are they going to put it on maybe the Spirit of Tasmania or something? Maybe someone's going to accidentally eat it on the Spirit or something?
Hey, so I want to go back to this tag. So on the tag it says reward, which sounds promising. What's the reward?
What?
The reward was a T-shirt, a hat,
yeah.
A poster, and $10.
So, pretty good. You happy with that?
Yeah, I was pretty stoked with that.
Okay, all right. Well, if you're happy, it's not for me to complain.
Hey, Ryan, are you splitting the $10 with the Carmichael boys? Well, they get the hat and the T-shirt and you get the $10.
Yeah, no. We all got T-shirts and posters and everything. We all got it.
Oh, very, three T-shirts. Wow. Three, they really rushed out.
All of a sudden, not so bad.
Cha-ching.
Wear it with pride, Ryan. Wear those hats and T-shirts with pride. Thank you so much for joining us.
No worries. Thanks for having me.